Hello everyone. We have seen in the last video what is load line and cue point. I think most of you clear what is it. Load line, that means it is regarding with the load. Load means output, and it's a line. Its meaning is simple. For my particular voltage or particular input voltage and current, I am getting a particular output voltage and current. So that output voltage and current I can represent as a point, Cartesian coordinate, VCC, IC. So that you are seeing here, VCC, here VCC, IC is VCC, 0. Here IC is VCC by RC, VCC by RC. But VCC is 0. So this point is 0, VCC by RC. Whereas this point is VCC, 0. And these are the different points, infinite number of points in this line. They are actually the infinite possible number of output voltages and output current it can provide by this transistor for different voltage. So if I am giving 1 millivolt here, corresponding to that 1 millivolt, if 1 milliampere current is flowing here, corresponding to that 1 milliampere IB, I am saying if that 1 milliampere is this IBQ, I have a current IBQ. Corresponding to this IBQ, I will have one output current, that is IC. I am saying for 1 milliampere, I am getting 1 ampere at output. So for 1 volt, 1 milliampere current is flowing. For that 1 milliampere current, I am getting an output current 1 ampere. So current amplification factor, 1 milliampere to it is increased to 1 ampere, that is 1000 times. Then corresponding to this 1 milliampere, I am getting another voltage also here. Okay, that is, this line is intersecting with this load line. That voltage is the actual output voltage. If this is 1 volt, corresponding, I am getting here it is 10 volt. Then it is voltage amplification is 10 times. For this 1 volt, I am getting 10 volt. So like that, if I am changing from 1 volt to 2 volt, then it will change to another location. Corresponding current and voltage I am getting here. 3 volt, corresponding current and voltage I am getting. So all these possible points I am connecting together, I am getting a load line. And in which point it has to fix, that's also we have seen in the last video. I think you are clear. Along this, actually we are fixing a particular DC value, DC point. Actually it is known as DC biasing or Q point. For a particular DC value, we are fixing a Q point. Then, when we are giving a alternating current, AC signal with this one, if this is 5 volt DC, along that one, I am giving a 1 volt AC, 1 volt peak to peak, means 1 plus 1 volt and minus 1 volt. So, 5 volt DC is here, plus 1 and minus 1. So automatically you can imagine how this signal is coming here from 5 volt as reference plus 1, that is 6 volt. From 5 volt as reference minus 1, it is 4 volt. So this AC signal will clamp on this DC, that is 5 volt plus 1 and minus 1, that is 6 to 4, 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.4, like that 6. Then again decreasing to 5, then decreasing to 4.9, 4.8, up to 4, then again coming back to this location. So from the 0 reference location, this will clamp to 5. Then actually, if VBB is 5 volt, this Q point is fixed here. And that VBB is not changing, Q point is there itself. But when I am giving AC signal, 5 volt with AC means from 5 to it will change to 6, and 5 to it will decrease to 4. So automatically corresponding that Q coupon will change. When 5 volt increases to 6, automatically this input current is increasing. Input current increase means output current also increase, means it is going to here. Correspondingly, output voltages decrease. That is important of common emitter. When input voltage increases, input current increases, output current increases, but output voltages decrease. So in common emitter, input current and output current are in phase, but input voltage and output voltage are out of phase. Similarly, input voltage decreases to from 5 volt to 4 volt. Same example, 5 volt to 4 volt. Then automatically that correspondingly input current is decreases. So output current will decrease. So output current will decrease. Correspondingly output voltage is increasing. So they are in opposite phase. Then how we can easily understand this concept? You take one pipe. Already I said this example. You take one pipe. Actually this pipe, from where the top portion of this pipe, which is taking the water, it is collector, equivalent to this portion, collector. Then this portion, it is equivalent to this portion, base. And this portion, that is after this tap pipe, it is connected to tap from the remaining portion of pipe, that is emitter. Imagine the case, you are just open and close this pipe continuously. Imagine the case, in the very beginning this is closed, the entire tap is closed. If the entire tap is closed, then what will happen? There won't be any water, means no water is coming to here. So the water at outputs to the output, it will be zero. No water will be here. And gradually, if you have open the tap slowly, if you open this tap slowly, then what will happen? Slowly this tap, this portion is opening, then slowly water will start to flow. Then you are completely open this one. When you are completely open this tap, then what will happen? The full water will start to flow. The full water, it will start to flow from the top portion to bottom portion. So you can see it will be like this. So when you are closing completely, no water at output. When you are open, completely open, the full water will comes. Then imagine the case, we are just open and close like this. Then what will happen? A stream of water will start to flow somewhat like this. Isn't it? A stream of water. When you are completely open, then full water will comes. When you are full water will comes here. When you are completely close, the water amount will decrease. Again, when you are completely open, full water will be there. When you are completely decrease, no water will be there. Like that, the movement of this tap will reflect on the flow of water. So actually what happens there? Your motion of hand, that reflected on the a big flow of water. Similarly, there is a AC signal, its movement, that is reflecting on the large movement of DC current. How this happens? When voltage at this point is increasing, that time reverse bias at this point is decreasing. So as the reverse bias is decreasing, this junction will become forward bias, large amount of current will flow, that is IC is increasing. Correspondingly, voltage across these two terminals is decreasing. Then if you are decreasing the voltage at this point, correspondingly reverse bias of this junction is increase. As the reverse bias increase, the current flow will decrease. So as you are giving the voltage here As the voltage increases, this junction will be forward bias and large amount of current will flow. As the voltage decreases, junction will be decreased, become reverse bias and minimum quantity of current is flowing. So as the movement of AC signal, up and down of AC signal, that is actually forward bias, the changing the biasing of collector base junction. In another way, we can say just similar to tap is open and close, similar to that. Corresponding to that, the big stream of water, sorry, big stream of current which is flowing through here, it is oscillating, just similar to an AC signal. Similar to this AC signal. So like this, we are getting actually amplification. This is the just example or easy understanding how amplification is happening. But so if you are not giving, or if you are completely open this tap, a full amount of water is flowing. That full amount is equivalent to a DC signal, this Q point. So where this Q point has to keep, that Q point, it should be between these two points, from this and this, that is between saturation and cutoff. So it is better to keep the Q point exact middle portion and maximum up and maximum down it will permit. If it is going beyond that one, it will lead to clipping. That's also I have shown to you in the last video what is clipping. Clipping means it is nothing but if you are taking this, this is a sine wave somewhat like this. If this is a sine wave, then if okay, this is sine wave, this top portion is, we are losing this top portion, that is clipping. The ended this top portion is, I am considering this as a sine wave. This top portion, this much top portion, if it is losing, then after this there is no signal. So this is known as clipping. To avoid that clipping, if it is going to positive saturation region, the positive half cycle will clip. If it is going to reverse negative region, the negative half cycle may clip. That may change. That depends on the condition. If you are taking voltage signal and current signal, depends on that, it may change. But anyway, if it is going to beyond the saturation, sorry, active region, one of the side may be clipped. To overcome that situation, we are going to keep this Q point exact in a fixed location, and depends on the Q point, where the position of Q point, we are able to know what is the maximum range of input signal I can give. If I am keeping Q point here, maximum range of input signal is this much. If I am keeping here, I can give this much one half cycle, but for a second half cycle only this much range I am able to give. So without any clipping, I am able to give only this much signal. If I am giving the Q point this point, I am able to give this much negative half cycle, but positive half cycle may clip after this one. So for without distortion, I can give only this much range. So if I want to give both the half cycle in equal range, I have to keep Q point in the exact middle location. So that is the importance of biasing. I think all of you clear the exact working. Thank you. Thank you all.